Hi, welcome to Harmony with Su-Lynn. In part 3 of the Master Controller tutorials, I'll show you how to create a grid wizard for your character rig using designed character head poses. We'll generate a grid wizard which determines the direction your character's head is facing, which removes the need for the animator to create poses manually that can lead to inconsistency or going off model if it is a complicated rig. So let's start. You'll need to design and animate a simple head with a face on separate drawing layers and with separate pegs for the face and head. Keep it simple when testing this approach. This will only work with keyframe animation, although hybrid animation, a combination of paperless and keyframe animation, will work. Once your character head is rigged, you can start posing it in different directions. Animate on threes, add a keyframe every 3 frames. I'm going to animate my character, Mr. Orange's head, facing in different directions. Start with the head looking screen left in a side angle pose. Select the face peg and move it in position. You can also position the pupils so they look left. Move the playhead along using shortcut full stop or right angle bracket to frame 4 and add a keyframe. Pose the face in a left three-quarter downward pose, and then a center downward pose. Now let's pose the head in the screen right direction. A right three-quarter downward pose, right side angle pose, next the upward poses, so the character's head moves in an upward arc path of action. Right three-quarter upward pose, center upward pose, left three-quarter upward pose, and finish with a front-on neutral pose. If you have drawing substitutions, you can change the mouse shapes to suit the head poses for some fun change of expression. You should have 9 keyframes. Save, and now let's add the master controller. Right-click on either the tool panel or timeline and select master controller to add the control to your interface where you prefer. You can also go to Windows, Toolbars, Master Controllers. Select all 9 keyframes on the timeline and then select the Grid Wizard here. The Master Controller Grid Wizard dialog box opens up. On Load Preset, click the arrow and select a preset. There's a few to choose from, or you can choose New to make your own grid. Let's choose 3x3 as we have 9 keyframes. Hit OK. Move the Master Controller Grid Wizard dialog box above the timeline so you can see your keyframes. Select the first keyframe and the position on the grid. It will name the keyframe automatically by the frame number. Hit OK. You can add a name in the identifier if you wish. Select the next keyframe, 4, and next position on the grid. I'm going to continue placing the keyframes in an anti-clockwise direction on the grid, finishing on the last keyframe, 25, with the front neutral pose in the center position on the grid. In Output, name the Grid Wizard. You can filter attributes and then hit Create. Select the top composite for the master controller to attach to. It will save the master controller in the scripts folder of your project folder. Once the grid wizard is generated, close the dialog box. Add a peg, Command P, to the master controller and add a backdrop. Move the grid to the position you want using the translate tool. To avoid any unwanted changes, always test the master controller away from the source animation where there aren't any keyframes. Open up the master controller properties or the layer properties panel where you can customize the grid wizard widget. You can uncheck show limits and just leave the widget showing and change the widget size and color or show limits and grid lines. Place it over the head so the widget coordinates with the direction the head is facing. Here's a pro tip. Create another file by saving as a new document and make a one-frame template that is ready to be animated. Delete all the keyframes and collapse the scene length to 1 frame. When you're reopening a file, select the Master Controller Grid Wizard node and select Show Master Controllers. Select the named Master Controller and hit OK. In the next tutorial, we'll cover how to generate a grid wizard for cell shading. Thanks for watching. See you next time!